The greatest concern is that we could shoot down a Russian aircraft because its actions are seen as a threat to our air or ground forces, said Lieutenant Col. Damien Pickart, the spokesman for U.S. Air Force's Central Command. As coalition leaders have repeatedly said, we're here to fight ISIS, not the Russians or anyone else, he added. The concern comes as the U.S. military has accused Russia and Syrian regime aircraft of violating policies that were agreed to by the United States and Russia to prevent such accidents. We saw anywhere from 6 to 8 incidents daily in late November, where Russian or Syrian aircraft crossed into our airspace on the east side of the Euphrates River, Pickart said. Over the past week or so it has decreased slightly, but the frequency of encounters remains a concern that we address in the daily deconfliction calls, Pickart added, referring to the pre-established hotline that allows military officers from Russia and the US-led coalition to talk to each other. A senior U.S. defense official told CNN last month that U.S. military aircraft flying over Syria in the last few weeks had been subjected to unsafe flying practices by Russian aircraft on several occasions. The New York Times published additional details of those unsafe encounters on Friday. President Donald Trump and Russian President Vladimir Putin pledged to continue to uphold those deconfliction measures in their recent joint statement issued on the sidelines of the APEC conference in Da Nang, Vietnam. The statement said Trump and Putin agreed to maintain open military channels of communication between military professionals to help ensure the safety of both U.S. and Russian forces and deconfliction of partnered forces engaged in the fight against ISIS. Officials have said that part of that arrangement involves defining where Russia and U.S. aircraft operate, with those operations historically being separated by the Euphrates River, which runs to Syria, with U.S.-backed forces operating to the east of the river and Russian regime forces to the west. But in recent days the Russian Ministry of Defense has publicly said its bombers and other aircraft have increasingly operated to the east of the river, bringing them closer to U.S. operations. Pickart said the area where most of the concerning encounters have occurred is in the airspace over the middle Euphrates River valley between the Syrian town of Mayadan and the Iraqi border, where the U.S.-backed Syrian Democratic Forces and Iraqi government troops are fighting the remnants of ISIS. He added that this area is where we aim to annihilate as many of them as possible, referring to the ISIS fighters. Pickart said that while the conversations on the deconfliction line continue and have remained professional for the most part, he added that what our air crew encounter in the air has not always reflected what was agreed to in those discussions. It's been a challenge for our pilots to discern whether this is deliberate on the part of the Russian pilots, or if these are just honest mistakes, he added. America's top military officer, chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, Gen. Joseph Dunford, spoke on the phone Wednesday with his Russian counterpart, Gen. Valery Gerasimov, according to a spokesman for the Joint Staff. However, the spokesman would not offer details as to what was discussed. Both have agreed to keep the details of their conversations private, U.S. Navy CDR. John Favier said.